person that has witnessed the change and impact this program's culture has had. I can truly say we've all been blessed the last 4 years to be at the forefront of college baseball. It has been an incredible experience for TCU, our fans, and of course it's all because of our alumni that put us in the right direction to become who we are today. I constantly remind the new guys that everything that they have now is because of those who came before them. And Coach always tells us, to whom much is given, much is expected. And over the years, that has consistently increased. But so does the talent, so does the incredible human beings we get that come into our program to further continue our tradition here. For me, I was introduced to TCU baseball as a 15-year-old playing in the New York Baseball Mets Academy in the Dominican Republic. My dad told me that the academy was playing a friendly exhibition game against a college from Texas. And one of his shortstops got called up to big league mini camp. So he needed a shortstop, so he asked me to fill in. So I did. On that day, a team in purple came across the field. And as 15-year-old Dominican kids, we would look at them and, I mean, as Connor said, nobody wears purple that much. And we called them gringos. So when we saw the gringos coming, we would say, los gringos vienen a jugar los morados. That's, the purple Americans are coming to play against us. And that team had TCU all across their jerseys, and they whooped us those 2 days. It was incredible. They were bigger than us, faster than us, stronger than us. They played a more technically sound baseball than us, and it was incredible to see. I was shocked. I didn't know baseball could be played with such discipline, with such a mentality, with such a focus, that it impressed me. It impressed my parents that were at the games, and it started, a conversation started within my family of, hey, maybe you should go to college. And for every Dominican kid, it's basically how it works is you, at 15 or 16, you sign with a professional baseball academy, and then you go through that rigorous training to see if you make it to the United States, and then you have to go through the minor leagues. So after my mom convincing my dad to let me go to college, I got in touch with Coach Sloss, and I asked if he remembered me. And he did. It's actually incredible. I remember emailing him, and he said, I remember you were the shortstop those 2 days, and, you know, why don't you come out to a camp? I have a camp in July, and, we'll see how you do, and we'll see what happens. And it was one of those moments where I was at the right spot at the right time. And he invited me. You know, I played well at camp, but the most important thing for me was to play with the same focus as his players had played against me when I was 15. That was the most important thing for me. I wanted to show him that, you know, I could play the way his players did. And, you know, I ended up playing well. We had a conversation. And Coach told my mom several things. He said these words, and I remember these words to this day. I can't promise you he's going to be successful here. That's on him. I can't promise you he'll get the chance to have playing time. That's on him. But what I can promise you is that I will do everything in my power to take care of him like he is my own. Make him a part of our family and develop him to become the best version of himself that he could possibly become. And after that meeting, the rest is history. Coming to TCU has been the greatest decision of my life. I showed up a little boy, but now I feel like I'm the best version of myself. I believe that is what this program strives for. Your effort and work means absolutely nothing if you're an incredible baseball player, but a terrible human being. And to be completely honest with you, you won't be able to last here if you didn't apply our core values in all the areas of your life. Selfless, energy, and excellence. That's what it means to be part of this program. Life is not about you, it's about serving others, helping each other grow in weak areas of your life, and using your strengths to further benefit your teammates, classmates, and ultimately the TCU community. A community and environment that gives you all the resources to be successful. You have to show up every day and be accountable. Be positive and know that in your mind, it could always be worse. So why be sad when you're walking into a multi-million dollar facility made just for you? The best medical staff that you serve you selflessly on a daily basis. You have one of the best strength and conditioning coaches in the country, and a player's lounge in your locker room that rivals big league clubhouses. That's why you show up with energy every day. This program, however, wouldn't be what it is without the demand for excellence. Every play, every pitch. You control what you can control and make sure your attitude and effort is where it should be. And the thought process behind that is, in the case you fall short of excellence, you will be very good at what you are doing. That's why we preach how you do anything is how you do everything here. That is what we are about. While being on this program and on this journey, you find yourself. And what I mean by that is, you kind of find a phrase that you live by. And after my redshirt sophomore year, I found mine. And that phrase is, being where your feet are. And if you were to ask me the million-dollar question, what do I know now that I wish I would have known then, and everything it applies to, I would tell you that being where your feet are relates to living in the present moment. The most important thing happening in life is whatever I'm doing at that present moment right now. It's talking to you guys, sharing my experiences, and ultimately that changed my life in a program that basically changes men's lives. Your energy and your excellence, you have to dedicate it on everything you do, every moment. And then you apply that to your loved ones. You apply that to your social life. You apply that to your academics. You apply that to your nutrition, and so on and so forth. Coach Bo and Coach Loss always remind us that the most important thing we do during practice is whatever we are doing at that current moment. And I've always been appreciative of that. I walk in every day to Lupton Stadium with the jersey with my number that I am recognized for. It doesn't matter my situation, if I'm starting or not, if I'm hot with a bat or in a slump, I'm hurt or healthy. I have an appreciation for what the TCU baseball family has given me. And what they have given me is an opportunity to become something more. I want to thank our coaching staff for being father figures, especially for me. Our admiration for the love you show us and your families is something we hope to have have one day. I want to thank Meredith for being like our mom. She always knows the answer to every question, and she knows the best way to get things done. Her kindness and work ethic towards making sure we're in the most comfortable spots possible is unbelievable. Thank you for making life as a student athlete much easier. I want to thank Miss Judy and Miss Erica for helping me achieve one of my dreams, and that's graduating from a four-year college. I'll be getting my well-earned diploma in economics in May.
All right.
Academics in a way where I would set myself up to be comfortable my last year. I want to especially thank her for all the motivational talks. She was helped. By the way, this semester for me, my fifth year, I have rock climbing and racquetball.
Good man. Good man. Respect a lot out of you. In racquetball.
I want to thank Nano for always being there for me when I needed him. Because if I was in the training room asking him for help, it was usually pretty bad. Your patience and expertise is what keeps us fresh and ready to go. And I want to personally thank Coach Zach Dakin for changing my life and being a big part of who I am today. Your patience with a 160-pound Dominican kid that has never touched a weight in his life really helped me get through those rough days. You were always there daily, helping me improve, making sure I didn't cut corners, and that I was doing everything possible to become the best version of myself. I came to you weak, mentally and physically, but you always pushed me to become more, and because of you, I actually had a chance to compete at a high level. Without you, I wouldn't be who I am today, a strong-willed individual that doesn't cut corners, an individual that has climbed the toughest mountain that has impacted me and my whole life. And that's, I was always made fun of growing up for being skinny and weak. I never showed people that weakness in person throughout my whole life, but I used to go home and cry to my mom all the time asking her why God made me like this. After being in this program and meeting you, I don't worry about those things anymore. So I thank you for giving me that confidence, the tools necessary to change my body, and ultimately giving me the blueprint to gain those 50 pounds that have changed my life. speech by thanking all the donors, fans, and support staff for being there for us when we needed you. Your contributions to this program ultimately change lives and make being a TCU Horned Frog that much sweeter. Thank you, everybody, and go Frogs.
Great job, man. How about that return on investment, folks? Done?
Yeah. Yeah. Very good.